Hi, in this video we're going to talk about tough crops. Specifically, we're going to talk about Calibrachoa. Calibrachoa is a wonderful crop. It's probably the number two hanging basket crop we grow, but there are some problems that are common to it. And those two basic problems are yellowing of the new growth of the plant, which is typically caused by an iron deficiency. And second, there are issues with root disease with the crop. So the first main problem with Calibrachoa is the yellowing of the new growth on the plant. So we take a look here. I have one as an example. What happens is on the new growth we get what we call interveinal chlorosis, which is the new leaves turn yellow and the veins between are green. And that's typically a symptom of an iron deficiency, but it could also look like a manganese deficiency too, so it's best to have it tested. So again, you can kind of see that yellowing in the new growth that's occurring. Now, what could cause an iron chlorosis or this type of problem? There's a couple of different things. First, you want to look at your fertilizer application rate. Most of us use packaged fertilizers to fertilize our crops. So the problem is if you feed at a low fertilizer application rate, you're also applying less rate or lower rate of iron, which can cause this type of problem. Second thing you want to look at is the pH. Plants such as Calibrachoa are sensitive to high pH. Typically, you want to grow the crop between 5.5 and 6.2. If your pH starts to go up above 6.2 to 6.5, it makes iron difficult for the plant to take up. So it becomes kind of locked up, if you want to say. And the last thing you want to look at is when you look at the crop, you want to look at the root system. Now, in this Calibrachoa crop, you can see our root system is nice and white, but in some crops, you can actually see it starts to turn brown. When you see brown roots, that's an indication you have a root disease, which that's where your growing media is where your nutrients are taken up. That can also cause a yellowing as well. Now, to correct an iron deficiency, you want to look at a couple of things. First of all, your fertilizer application rate. If it's too low, it may need to be increased. Next, you want to look at using an iron chelate. There are various iron chelates out in the market. The one we recommend, or the one that works the best, is iron E-D-D-H-A, which is your best chelator. There's iron DTPA, which works fairly well, and the standard EDHA, which is a little bit less effective. But if you use the iron EDHA, it'll probably correct this problem, probably with just one application is all it's required for the entire season. Second most common problem we see with Calibrachoa would be issues with root disease caused by Thalaviopsis and Pythium. Both organisms like wet growing conditions, so you want to try to dry out the growing media as much as possible to try to avoid those organisms becoming active. So as an example, we take a look at the media surface of Promix. Generally speaking, when it's wet, Promix has kind of a dark brown to almost black color because of the peat being wet. Well, if we let that dry down to a light brown to tan color, that's really a good indication of when it's time to water. We also want to try to reduce the humidity levels in the greenhouse by opening up the vents and allowing the humid air to escape. And we also want to look at running fans to help try to take the humid air around the plant canopy and move it out and replace with the drier air above, try to encourage more dry down. And encouraging dry down will help to accelerate water usage by the plant, so it'll dry out the growing media faster. Other tips that'll help is using something such as Promix HP. HP will help with drainage, and if you bring it or have it with the biofungicide and the mycorrhizae, biofungicide will help suppress your root disease, and a mycorrhizae will help with nutrient uptake. And since a lot of times these disease organisms are more common in the earlier time, specifically in the early spring, late winter time, again, that's where Promix HP with biofungicide plus mycorrhizae will benefit you most. Other factors to look at is cultivar selection. Some Calibrachoa grow very rapidly, they're very vigorous. They're much less likely to see root disease problems versus the compact ones that are slower, more steady type growth. All those tips will help to reduce your root disease problems on your Calibrachoa crop. Thank you.
For more information, visit our website. Follow us on social media.